Good morning.
Good morning. Thanks for the coffee. I need it. I had the strangest dream last night.
Oh, yeah? Interesting. Tell me about it, Sharon.
I dreamed... Good morning. I'm really glad to be joining you this morning.
I am Angelo Pizone, the principal. I'm so glad to welcome you here. Unfortunately, I am extremely busy today, so I'm gonna have to leave. Vice Principal Jefferson is in charge, and as you know, he really runs the school, so you have the best leader here. You can fill me in later as needed.
Okay, great.
Call me Sean. I'm excited to tell you, we already have a lot of initiatives already in place to support equity in our school. Everyone gets along, we love our students, and it is a great school. That said, I'm happy to organize an hour-long professional development presentation so you can present to all our teachers about equity. We have an open PD time to fill. Oh dear, I see a problem with a few students popping up. I may need to take this. Our students are our priority, of course. I'll send you the date and time for the PD.
I'm Susan Jasper, the school counselor. My colleague Cindy and I do all recruiting of students from sending schools. We offer school tours, visit and present at sending schools, host student events, and conduct all admissions screening and acceptance. It's a heavy load, and I have to tell you, our schedule is already overwhelming. We can't add anything else.
I see.
I'm Mr. Cornwallis. I've run a machining here for 15 years, and it's very regulated by state and federal guidelines, so I can't change much, if anything. In addition, I have tried to recruit girls for years, and they just don't want to enter the field, so I don't know why we keep being hassled about it. Shouldn't we let kids follow their own interests?
Isn't this about normalizing machining and highlighting manufacturing opportunities?
I just think we need better students. Skill, ability, interest. The teachers are doing everything they can. If students drop out, it's because we enroll the wrong students.
Hi, Miss Ortega. I'm taking notes. Principal Davis asked me to be here to help you. I have lunch menus.
Oh, I have to get going to a sending school to make a presentation. I'm so glad Ms. Ortega is here to take notes. I'll read them later.
As the teacher union representative, I have to go to a teacher mediation. I have two teachers fighting with administration. We need to make sure our voices are heard.
Well, I need to order lunch for everyone to get it on time.
The dream ended with me staring out the window at everyone running away.
Wow, that's not a dream, that's a nightmare. Let's get started. Good morning, everyone. Thanks for joining us again for our weekly equity team meeting. You all know Sharon Hernandez, who represents our English language learning program. She'll be joining us from here on out to help us better understand the needs and the assets of our new families from Mexico and Colombia, and how we can work together to best support our international children.
Glad that was just a dream. I'm really happy to join you all.
We're delighted to have you join us and look forward to hearing your ideas.
I also want to welcome Mr. Stevens, the lead teacher in culinary arts. Mr. Stevens is going to update us on his work on relevance in culinary arts, and I'm looking forward to hearing about his new community garden. I am working with 4-H to develop a plan for selecting fresh vegetables for the students to grow. There is a lot of interest in farm-to-table eating. Also, a local church is volunteering to help water and care for the plants if they can have extra produce for their low-income families. I want my students to connect cooking to health and community well-being. Great. I am also pleased to invite Jonas Smith, who is one of our culinary arts student ambassadors. He will be serving on this team as well.
It's great to be here. I'm really excited about the community garden, but it has already hit a snag. We need more tools, shovels, and trowels.
I'm on it. I can work with the students in my program together with the carpentry program to make the tools we need. Our new 3D printer can help with that too.
I knew I picked the right school and the right career. Thank you.
Thank you. Now, Ms. Ortega is going to share the data she analyzed from the annual student surveys we